Hi church, well welcome to December the 20th and it's getting near to Christmas, isn't it? It's creeping closer and we've had a lot of changes come our way, haven't we? But one thing we need to hold on to today is that our God is the same, is that he doesn't change, that he is a rock in which we can place our feet and be stable and secure, and his word does not change. And we're going to look at his word today and just meditating on the thought that our God is, Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever. We're going to talk about one of the prophecies made in the Old Testament about the coming of Jesus today, and it's a prophecy from Micah chapter 5 verse 2. So I'll just read it for you. But you, O Bethlehem Ephrata, are only a small village among the people of Judah. Yet a ruler of Israel whose origins are in the past will come from you on my behalf. So this was a promise of the coming Messiah. And it was a promise, a declaration made over a little village called Bethlehem, a small, poor, insignificant village that didn't have any massive power or influence. Nobody important lived there. And yet the most important person that ever was to be born on earth was going to be born there. And it says, although you are only a small village among the people of Judah, yet a ruler of Israel will come from you. And God can do amazing things with small people, with small places, with places that others have discarded, with people that others have discarded. The Bible tells us that he chooses the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. And this is a similar sort of concept. The Lord picks out this little village and chooses it to be the birthplace of the Messiah. Do you know this morning that God has put greatness in you? There is a seed of greatness in you. He wants to do significant things through you. And he can see you in a way that you cannot see yourself. Perhaps you live in an area that other people look down on. We live in an area that is poor and deprived. And yet God is interested in those areas as well. And he has his hand on those areas as well. And he has great plans for those areas as well. So as we begin to pray over our neighbourhoods, let's begin like this prophecy to declare good things over it, that greatness is going to be born and it's going to flourish in our neighbourhoods. Let's pray today that God will release everything that he's got for us within our hearts, and that we will begin to bear all the fruit that he is destined for us to bring. So even though you may feel small, even though you may feel insignificant, even though you may be aware of your flaws and your limitations, know that God wants to do something great in you today. Let's just pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you that you chose the small village of Bethlehem to be the birthplace of the Messiah. And I thank you that that also demonstrates how you love to use small things, insignificant things, things that others have discarded. And Lord, I thank you for that. I thank you for your kind nature that chooses to work in this way. And we pray, Lord, I pray for everyone that feels small, that feels limited, that feels insignificant, that you will show them how much you want to use them and bless them and enlarge them today. And we pray over the neighbourhoods that each of us represent. And we pray that you would do something, you would birth something of you in these neighbourhoods today. We think particularly of Kensington, where our church is based, that you would do something beautiful and wonderful and enlarge your kingdom in that area. In the name of Jesus, amen. I hope you are blessed today.